thrown around the area. This is pictures from the back of the White House, our live CNN camera position there.
Do the crowd seem to be building as each day goes by, Steve?
Well, the crowd had numbered anywhere between 500 and 2,000 at the back of the White House, perhaps 3,000 at its height when this cordon was put up late last week and all of these people were evicted. As they left to go home to freshen up and to see family, they weren't allowed back in. Pardon me, nightly now, since then, there have been minor scuffles with police as demonstrators tried to get back through the cordon that is surrounding the White House. Most often this happened behind the White House at the Barakadnaya metro station. Yesterday, as you know, there were violent clashes in front of the foreign ministry. Perhaps 1,000 or a few more at that time. Perhaps 500 demonstrators reformed there today, but there had been a call for a major demonstration at October Square, where this group came from. Probably, as I said, about 5,000 people who broke through police barricades repeatedly, marching along Moscow's Garden Ring Road from October Square, where there's a giant statue of Vladimir Lenin, a rallying point for these mainly communist demonstrators. They marched along that road past Gorky Park, over the Moscow River, past the foreign ministry, and on to the White House, where we see them now. It's a huge crowd now massing behind the White House, listening to people address them. A very emotional moment for these people here to have regained their turf.
Is it not true, Steve, that many of these people, if not most of them, are very, very disappointed in the way that the reforms have gone? They're not happy with these reforms, and they're certainly not happy with the speed in which they have taken place.
Well, these people are a core group, and I wanted to talk about that, Ralph, a little bit. A core group of people who have periodically demonstrated over the past months against Boris Yeltsin, against just what you said. Their disappointment in the way Russia is going, the reforms that Boris Yeltsin is trying to implement. They want the old Soviet Union back. They're rallying behind Alexander Rutskoi, a hero of the Afghan War, who has himself said inside that White House that it's time to try to reform the Soviet Union. Of course, that's a very difficult task in this day and age. So these are a hardcore group of people, very much opposed to Boris Yeltsin, very much opposed to his economic reforms, his political reforms, people who liked the way it was when there was Soviet Union and a communist party ruling this country. And the point should be made that while you're seeing some very dramatic pictures, we heard gunfire on live television, that most of Moscow is still calm. Virtually all of Moscow is still calm. A city of 9 million people with 5,000 of those people demonstrating noisily. So these pictures give you a very skewed view of how the country is feeling as a whole, I believe, but they certainly do show you the drama of this political standoff in its 13th day since Boris Yeltsin disbanded parliament and ousted Alexander Rutskoi as vice president and called for new parliamentary elections in December, later saying that he himself intends for early elections in June. Ralph?
Steve, following up with what you were talking about just a moment ago, your best guess, the number of people who are opposed to the Yeltsin reforms and the ones who are supporting Yeltsin, who feel that his are the good ideas, the best ideas, who is ahead in all of this?
Well, Ralph, there's no good polling information nationwide, but best guess around here is that somewhere between 50% and 55% of the nation supports what Boris Yeltsin is trying to do, whereas somewhere between 16% to 18% are represented by these people who have again massed at the White House, who violently broke through police lines today and are supporting Alexander Rutskoi and Ruslan Khasbulatov and the 100 or so hardline deputies of the Congress of People's Deputies that are still holed up inside the White House for the 13th day of the standoff here. So the broader support still seems to be well behind President Boris Yeltsin, with a small minority supporting Alexander Rutskoi and wanting to go back to the days of communism. Once again, with a picture of our live camera from the balcony at the rear of the White House.
And these are the people, I suppose, you need that don't even see any elections take place, correct?
And the only thing that these people would like to see elections take place for president. But this crisis here, Ralph, seems to have moved beyond the issue of elections. We don't even hear talk about trying to negotiate over who runs for office or when, who runs for office or when. It's now just a raw and naked struggle for power in the country. With that gunfire we heard, it moved even closer to a violent struggle for power. I find it hard to imagine that this day will close without some further violence. I hate to predict such a thing, but there is so much tension around the White House and these few square blocks with these masses of people shoved together, surrounded by troops with guns, and the soldiers and the police who tried to stop them very much lost faith, are in disarray, and I'm sure that there are bound to have been a goodly number of injuries along this march as the demonstrators broke through police lines, injuries on both sides.
Steve, we heard about a week ago, I believe it was, that some members of parliament were saying if all of this doesn't get settled pretty soon, they're going to move to another city, just leave Moscow altogether. Have you heard any more about that?
Now, there's Alexander Rutskoi preparing to address the crowd. He was Boris Yeltsin's running mate during their elections in June 1991. He was a close ally of Boris Yeltsin. Just listen to him, see what he has to say.
Young people, combat ready men. Everybody should be forming detachments, and we should now attack the mayor's office on the Ostankino, and we should assault those two buildings and win. Everybody who's strong enough, I'm asking old men and women to stay away from this operation, all the other ones, for combat ready, get together, form detachments, attack the mayor's office, and then let's go on to
I heard you.
The Ostankino television center. Don't worry, all this scum of society will be put behind the bars. And the everybody who issued orders to beat up the demonstrators. I was listening to these orders via this police video. I'm now appealing to the law enforcement agencies and personnel of the law enforcement agencies. You have just seconds before you can take the side of the people. I would like to warn everyone who is in these detachments. All your names are listed. You will be held responsible before the law. I ask you to defect to the people and all the demonstrators. I'm asking to do this. Stand up. Take positions on the left-hand side. Let us form detachments now and attack the mayor's office. Please be as disciplined as you can. It should all be a very organized matter. We should be doing
violent,
it in a very...
saying that the demonstrators should now form into brigades and attack the Moscow mayor's office and far across town, the Russian television broadcasting center called Ostankino. We have tape now ready to go for you of what it sounded like here and what it looked like when those gunshots went. Listen to that.